Since its humble beginnings, the Indianapolis 500 has been the premier event in American automobile racing. For almost 100 years now, drivers from all across the world have flocked to the Speedway every Memorial Day weekend for a chance to fuel the dream and reach racing immortality. In 91 running, 709 drivers have started the run, accepting the challenge the Brickyard presents to them. While so many have tried, only 67 have succeeded, conquering the 500 miles. While some have reached victory lane on more than one occasion, others consider just making the field a victory itself. Today, 33 of the fastest have once again accepted the challenge. And with that, it is now time to take a look at the starting field for the 92nd running of the Indianapolis 500. Starting on the pole at a speed of 226.366 miles an hour from Auckland, New Zealand, Scott Dixon. In the middle of row 1, 2005 race winner, Dan Weldon. And on the outside, making his first start at Indy for Team Penske, last year he drove for Luso Dragon, Ryan Briscoe. Moving to row number 2 is 2-time winner, Elio Castroneves, last year's Dancing with the Stars winner. And in the middle is 2005 Rookie of the Year and Motegi winner this year, Danica Patrick. On the outside of her will be last year's pole sitter, Tony Kanaan. Moving to row number 3, a man who almost won this event in 2006 and almost last year as well, Marco Andretti. And in the middle is always a threat, Vitor Mirit. On the outside of him, the fastest rookie in the field, Hideki Muto, driving for Andretti Green Racing. Moving to row number 4, the Menards colors are back once again at the Brickyard as Ed Carpenter is at the wheel for Vision Racing. And in the middle, Thomas Schechter, who had a strong run here in 2002 for Eddie Cheever. On the outside of him, Dreyer and Reinbold's fastest entry with Townsend Bell. He returns to the Brickyard with strong hopes. The inside of row number 5 sees the son of a legend as Graham Rahal makes his rookie start for Newman Haas Lanigan Racing. And in the middle is the first of two A.J. Foyt cars with Darren Manning at the wheel. On the outside of them is the 2002 pole sitter driving for Dale Coyne Racing, Bruno Junqueira from Brazil. The inside of row number 6 sees the other Newman Haas Lanigan car with fellow rookie Justin Wilson at the wheel. And in the middle is 2004 race winner Buddy Rice in another Dreyer and Reinbold entry. On the outside of them is Davey Hamilton, who finished a solid ninth here last year. Row 7 sees a pair of rookies for Rahal Letterman Racing. The first is Alex Lloyd in the WeFit-sponsored entry. In the middle is Ryan Hunter Ray driving the ethanol-sponsored car. And on the outside of them, driving for Roth Racing, is veteran John Andretti, who crashed out in this race last year. The inside of row number 8 sees veteran Sarah Fisher driving for the first time for her very own team. And in the middle is rookie Australian Will Power driving for KV Racing Technology. On the outside is the second A.J. Foyt entry with Jeff Simmons at the wheel, who drove for Rahal Letterman in last year's race. The inside of row number 9 sees Oriol Servia, only the second Spaniard to start the race in the history. Alongside him, two Venezuelans fill out the row with E.J. Visa for HVM Racing and Milka Duno making her second start in the 500. Row number 10 sees three rookies. Mario Marias goes for Dale Coyne Racing, and then it's the Conquest Racing teammates. In the middle is Enrique Bernoldi, who has raced here on the Grand Prix course before, and on the outside is former Freedom 100 winner, Jaime Camara. Row 11 sees A.J. Foyt IV from Vision Racing, who suffered a hard crash here on Bump Day. The middle sees 1996 winner Buddy Lazier, who is driving for Hemelgarn Racing, that same team that carried him to victory in 1996. And rounding out the field is Marty Roth. That is the starting field for the 92nd running of the Indianapolis 500.